Good morning, hi. Welcome back here where we talk about BTS, midlife, mental health, how these things come together. I am all smiles today. I am not always all smiles. If you are new here, hi, welcome. It's so nice to meet you if you are willing to like introduce yourself or anything. And if you're not, it's really nice to like cosmically be hugging you anyhow, because isn't that one of the things we figured out from BTS? We never walk alone. We are hugged and loved and seen and heard, even if we're not feeling that in our life. I'm feeling good today. Today we're going to actually watch two music videos, and these are not first reactions. These are, I haven't seen them in a very long time, but I have seen them reactions. So if you're like needing a first reaction, my next music video is the one. The reason I'm reacting to videos that I've already seen is one, to gush. We need to take opportunities to gush about the guys. Two, to pursue feeling good. And I don't mean in that whole like hedonistic, I'm gonna do damage to myself and eat a whole box of brownies kind of feel good, though we're all guilty of that sometimes too. In order to make changes in our lives, and I am in the middle of a huge upheaval, huge transitions, you have to pamper yourself into feeling good. You have to pamper yourself into reminding that you are worthy. I am wearing my necklace, my pendant from Laurie. Thank you. You are such a beautiful soul. So many of you are so beautiful souls. Laurie, thank you for sharing yourself in this way. I feel like Jung right now, putting my hand up like that. Anyway, it's so beautiful. Oh my God. So beautiful. And it seems really appropriate because I'm reminding myself that it's okay for me to receive good things, because that's how I ended up in LA for permission to dance. I spent years and years feeling not worthy of so many things. I think if BTS hadn't released the song Permission to Dance the summer of last year, I don't think I would have given myself permission to have gone to LA. Now I'm on this path toward huge changes. Anyway, you guys hear way too much about me. We're not here for me. We're here to talk about BTS, right? Right. There are two videos that we're gonna take in. Then I will have seen everything leading up to Bulletproof the Eternal, which I haven't seen, and I have purposely held off seeing it because to my understanding, it references a lot of their previous videos and their previous journey up to that point. Let's watch the last two videos leading up to, last two videos that I haven't seen. Boy With Luv and Not Today. Should we do Not Today first, which is like, boom, kicking the day's butt, or should we do Boy With Luv first? Because Boy With Luv is so precious. I'm gonna do Not Today first, because I particularly am excited to see Boy With Luv, and both will make me happy, but I apparently like delayed gratification a little bit. I'm gonna be honest, these have been, through my full year as an ARMY, my two least favorite videos, and maybe even among my least favorite songs. However, especially Boy With Luv has grown back on me. I didn't like it a whole lot in the beginning. I didn't dislike it by any stretch, but it's cutesy. But I've also realized some of my issues with cutesiness was internalized misogyny and self-hatred that I was directing at, well, cutesy things, and that's bullcrap. These are men who rock our worlds with their talent, with their sexiness, and with their flower crowns and finger hearts. So we can embrace everything. And Hattori, Lord, I hope I'm saying your name right. Hattori, who I don't even think Hattori watches my videos anymore, but Hattori will always have a super, super special place in my heart. One of my very first ARMY friends here, he commented to me and chatted with me some in those first videos, and his heart is so sweet. He lives, I believe, in California, which is where I plan to move to. Boy With Luv, if I'm correct, was like his gateway into ARMY, and he has a very special place in his heart anyhow. And Halsey is so sweet, just like the whole song, the whole video, Hattori, and just our passion and love with all of this, right? I did all that talking about Boy With Luv, and we're gonna watch Not Today. My favorite memory of Not Today is PewDiePie watching it, and he watched it to make fun of K-pop, and instead absolutely thought BTS was badass, and that's super awesome. Let's get hyped for our day, and if you're going to sleep, let's get hyped for tomorrow. And tomorrow morning, I hope that you can carry this kind of energy into your day. Oh, these are gonna be our last times witnessing the big hit ball drop. It was such a gratifying little doop. So I get anxiety. I think that's part of why. I love their acting in this video, though. I do remember that. That is like a video game. It's meant to be, isn't it? Video game vibe. The sound, the look, everything. Even the way he's walking looks like a video game. I don't game, but I mean, I've seen enough. I'm from like the original NES generation. That's the graphics I'm used to. Graphics have gotten good. Whoa, his eyes were blue. How are you not hyped? No, not today. Oh my god. Namjoon with purple hair. Oh my god, this choreography. Oh my god, I forgot about this video. Oh my god, Jungkook. Holy hell, this is fun. Oh. Oh, I love the choreography. Look how intense they are. Why did I have a problem with this video? That was a cool transition. This scene gives me anxiety. Trust that we're together, trust that it's bulletproof. Is this song gonna make me cry? I need a pair of Jungkook pants. This part, it's a lot. It's a lot. Damn, Jimin. Damn. I should stop cussing, sorry. So I'm a crier. If you're new here, this is the year that I have declared we should have no shame for being in love with BTS, being in love with ARMY, being in love with being an ARMY, with feeling huge emotions that sometimes make us cry or make us laugh or make us smear lipstick on our face, which, by the way, I have to keep a mirror down here now because I've done that a few times. Not today. I will not feel bad. I will not feel bad for my soul feeling connected to and being sung to by and singing back with, being inspired by anything. I not today. What was it? Trust that the word together makes us bulletproof. That was paraphrasing. I clearly need to revisit the translation to that song. And oh my gosh, like, woo, that was good stuff. That was good stuff. So we're going to switch over to Boy With Luv, which tangent here about Boy With Luv. I've referenced now once or twice. There's a podcast called Speaking of Jung. It is an entire podcast dedicated to interviews with Jungian analysts with Laurie Brennan. I always have to skip like the first 3 or 4 minutes of any of them with Murray Stein. Murray Stein wrote Map of the Soul, the book, which is about Carl Jung's psychology, which BTS has based a lot of their discography on. And I'm sorry, you probably already know those things, but just in case you didn't. Both episode 42 and episode 44 are actually specifically about BTS and their album Map of the Soul Persona, which at that time, he didn't know there was gonna be Map of the Soul 7 coming out. Though, Murray Stein predicted that when he saw that Map of the Soul Persona was coming out and he listened to the songs and read the translations, he suspected that there would be follow-up album to it. Yeah, Dr. Murray Stein joins us from Zurich to discuss his book Jung's Map of the Soul, an introduction to its influence on the upcoming record Map of the Soul Persona by the Korean group BTS. And then in 44, the album has dropped. So this was all filmed in 2019, like 2/3 through episode 44 where they're talking about Map of the Soul. And he really goes in depth talking about Boy With Luv. Episode 54, Ego. Episode 55, Map of the Soul 7. So yeah, and that was in February of 2020. Anyway, if you're looking for a podcast to listen to that is insightful, psychology, BTS, and gives you like more depth and power into how profound and moving BTS and what they create is, then you might want to check that out. But regardless, when anybody in your life tries to diminish your light, or that this inspires you, or the connections that you're building from being ARMY, not today. That was hype. I can't believe that I spent a year giving that song and video a hard time in my head. Not again. Check out that podcast if you're so interested in more depth, because I honestly would not have thought there was depth to Boy With Luv. Isn't that one of the such a cool thing about BTS and the art they produce for us? If you're just going to enjoy it at a surface level, it's exquisite as it is. And then, whether by accident or whether by purpose, when you start seeing the petals of the flower of it just start to unruffle, start to bloom into these ruffles, it's like the ruffliest, most special, most spectacular flowers of just everything, mind, body, and soul. They create the most exquisite flowers in our magic garden, in the magic shop. Boy With Luv, Boy With Luv. Need to focus. All right, let's get on with the oh my. Are you ready? Hattori, you're probably not around here, but my heart is with you so often. I think of this sweet man and the conversations he shared with me. Hattori was definitely among the very first people that made me realize I really, really am not alone. How glorious it feels to be ARMY, even if you are feeling it alone. And Hattori, if by chance you are watching this video and I am saying your name wrong, please like correct me about where to put the emphasis or anything. I really hate disrespecting people by saying their names wrong, which is why I still struggle with Jungkook's name. I love him so much. Why can't I say his name well? Oh, big hit. I was like a hair too early on that. Ah, see, pink glitter. I don't have pink glitter eyeshadow. And hers is infinitely better to find. Oh, Persona Theater. God, how glorious of a concept. This, that tongue and that smirk, that's worth a backup. Can we do it? We can do it one more time. Sorry, we're not gonna make it through this video. It's gonna be an hour long. so worth again. She's so cute. I should have worn like big, happy, fluffy fake eyelashes. That would have taken work though. It's too early for that. Oh! Gosh, have mercy. Just look at their profile. They're gorgeous. Sorry. Ah! How does he do that? How does he do that? Oh, that smile. I'm not gonna get through this video. They're too beautiful. The smile. Oh my god. Ah, Jungkook's smile. Oh my god. Oh, those shoulders. That tongue. What are you doing? I'm not making it through this video. I take it back, Tori. I love this video. Look at Jake. Look at Jimin over here. Look at Namjoon over there. See, I always watch the front. Sorry, guys. Namjoon. I always watch the front. So, like, when I do pay attention to the back. J-Hope is rocking some side love this whole video so far. Oh my gosh, J-Hope. Oh my god. Ah! Did you see Tae's face? What is happening? Why can't I make it through this video? He is so expressed right here. Oh, sorry. There! Oh my god. I take it back. I love this video so much. What is wrong with me that I ever did? Jin! Jin looks so free right there. Oh, Youngie. Oh, that little bite. Oh. They're so funny and flirty. They all have blue eyes in this video? No. They don't. Oh, I love when their eyes are actually dark. So they look good with blue eyes too. In a painting. Taeyong is so extra. He is always ruffles, bell bottoms, and feathers, and red. Oh, Jin. Jin. Dangly earrings. Oh, that smile. Get it, Halsey. Oh, get it, Yoongi. Ah! How could I ever not love this video? Hot dang. Oh. He's so beautiful. Good God. Seriously, you've got to listen to the Speaking of Young podcast about this video. About this album. How did I not love this video? Don't you? Don't you? Namjoon's face. Namjoon. Somehow we made it through the video. Oh my god, that was so good. That was so good. That was so freaking amazing. Oh my.
my God, that was so happy. How did I not absolutely love everything about the song and video? Things hit us in different times in different ways, and everything that BTS offers us is so much that I don't think we're capable of taking it all in at once, especially if you're Dynamite Army like I am, or after Butter Babies. There's so much to take in, and some of you have done an amazing job devoted to taking in Run BTS and Bon Voyages, which no, I still haven't watched, and Soup, and all the videos and all the performances. Lord have mercy. What a vibe for the day. Jin with me. Oh my God. Okay, so I hope that these two songs and videos hype up your heart as much as they have done for mine. And like I said, whether you're starting your day right now, whether you are in the middle of your day and you're like needing some revamping for the rest of your day, or whether you are going to bed and need like tomorrow to wake up and feel like, ah, I have permission to just feel inspired and with love and all the things, then I hope that for you. God loves you, I love you, BTS loves you. Love yourself. Love yourself enough to pamper yourself into feeling good, to feeling like soul good. I'm not talking about like the stuff that actually long term is gonna do you wrong. Lean into the stuff that builds you up, lifts you higher, and I hope that I'm able to be part of that journey with you, or that you just find who is. So you never walk alone. I feel so like, corny, but this is the year I don't care if I feel corny. I love you guys. Sorry, I've been on like a very excited high for a few days now because I spent a couple weeks not feeling very good. And it's gonna be a rough year. So if you're new here and you haven't watched a lot of my old videos yet, you'll see I am willing to be really happy when I'm really happy, and I'm also willing to fall apart almost Trisha Paytas style on you and let you know that I'm struggle bus. And if that roller coaster is a bit much for you, then I understand. No one's for everybody, and I hope you have love with love everywhere you go. I usually wake up and I like to do morning meditations with BTS and God. And I'm not getting a lot of sleep these days because I have a 3-year-old who's potty training, so I am up every couple hours while he comes running through the house. So I decided, instead of like hopping into morning meditations, I was just gonna throw myself into some BTS meditation with you. That was a good meditation, right?